Guys, we're on. Welcome to Bloomex Podcast. We're on here with Gogol from Minion Labs, calling in from Bangalore. Gogol, how are you doing today?
I'm doing great. How about you?
Doing pretty good. It's the weather's kind of misty here, foggy. So got everyone kind of down. How about you? How's Bangalore?
It's midnight, 12:50 p.m. But currently, the street is known as out there.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think probably my apartment window is like bright, and apart from the whole street is dark.
Everyone else is sleeping. How's the nightlife usually in Bangalore before lockdown?
Bangalore is a party place. Been called as Pub City of India. A lot of pubs around. So I took an apartment in between more than 400 pubs. So, but nice. After lockdown, these pubs are closed and there is no much activities outside and it's dark outside totally.
How's that been for you socially? You feel like you're kind of closed off and isolated?
Yes, a bit more. I'm more of a traveler. I used to travel a lot for the business purpose, but in last couple of months, I literally felt like a jailbird. But now it's like a new normal, but adapted to this.
No, absolutely. But let's dive more into Minion Labs and your startup. Can you explain to us what Minion Labs does?
Sure. Minion Labs is an energy efficiency company where we have an IoT solution. At single point of connect in any building, be it a hospital, a hotel, or retail, at single point of connect, it can able to tell you each and every appliance level energy consumption data. For example, I'm installing one of our Minion at your house, the MCB panel, where if you switch off the whole building electricity, the electricity goes off. From there, it can able to sense each and every appliances, when it is on, when it is off, and what is its individual electricity consumption, whether it is performing up to the technical sheet whenever you buy electricity, an appliance, whether it is performing up to that mark or not. If it is not, what do you have to do? It's AI powered, and all you need to do is listen to the notifications and perform the action. And that gets you up to 30% of savings. So this is a daily day basis business. And it started from 2015. But the journey actually started from 2010. I was a state level hockey player, played for a state called Tamil Nadu in India. And so at 2010, there was a fight in the hockey league match. And I got my leg broke, which hospitalized me 3 to 4 months. Apparently that resulted in my 10th standard public school marks. And which affected me later at my college placement drives. So these placement companies used to have a cutoff, high school, and then if you have any diploma or else the undergraduate, everything above 60%, where I have diploma and undergraduate more than 60, but the high school part was little bit of 56. So I got rejected in more than 300 or 400 companies without even appearing for an interview. They just shortlisted, and these are all the rejected categories. They just moved on. And after 400 rejections, I secured an internship from Amazon through a coding competition. And I was the highest paid student of the year. And this happened at 2015. And I got into Amazon as a security expert. Within 8 months or 6 months to 8 months, I don't feel that IT arena is in for me. So I resigned it and started focusing on my dreams, which is innovation and electronics, which is my core. And that got me around 25 international awards so far. The first award is from Prime Minister Narendra Modi of India, directly from himself as India's second best innovation. And second award is from the utilities. In India, there are multiple states, and for each state, there is a utility. There's a president for all of these utilities. So that president awarded me a best energy efficiency award. And the third award is from Crown Prince of Dubai, as top 5th best innovation in energy category. So that's the outcome of Minion, which we are working out currently. And later that, I founded this company called Minion Labs, and there were a lot of research and development happened. And we eventually secured seed investment, angel investment, and one by one after. And we also got a recognition and a check amount from WhatsApp India, which is an initiative from Facebook. And also, until this COVID-19 lockdown, we were having around 232 enterprise clients, like major hospital chains, retail chains, real estate builders, and much more, who are using Minion Energy Management platform. In this COVID-19, the business was little dull. Like any other company, we were also like struggling a lot, because the most of the places where we install these products are commercial places. Because of the lockdown, almost all the commercial places are shut. And that energy efficiency is not the first point of, their worry currently. So right now they are looking for like somewhere more of how to escape from the corona, how to look for any other ways to like be productive. And we were in the like work from home, and out of a casual work from home calls, we come up with this unique solution called Minion UVSAF. Minion UVSAF is like a microwave box, and but it's not a microwave, it has a UVC lamps inside, where in current scenario it is even very starry, or like we need to take a lot of precautionary even to go for a supermarket to buy some groceries, because this COVID-19, the transmission is more in surface to human than human to human. And in these kind of, if someone who is affected by COVID-19 is like, they touch some grocery or any fruit or vegetable, it's been live there for next 24 to 72 hours. And if someone touches the same, they get affected. So how do we, avoid that? So this problem actually started, how do we came up with this? Like, I stay alone in Bangalore, and most of the time, all my 3 meals I used to order online and get the food and eat, and I don't cook myself, or I don't have any mates here. And now I felt like, if I buy any food from outside, will the food, the packet is safe? And how do I sanitize the package? Because it's a food, I can't apparently, rinse it with a bucket full of water, or like put hand sanitizer in the food. So that's how the problem came. And we came up with this solution. And later we thought like, why not we make some box like this and place it at each and every apartment. I live in a place around a lot of apartments here. So if we keep a common box product like this at the gate, where if there is 50 residents, they can, whatever they buy and come, they can just put it inside, sanitize, and they can take it safely back to their home. And then that came around with another problem. People felt insecure to use the common box. So they wanted the box for themselves, for each individual dedicated boxes. And since the box is very affordable, so there were a lot of purchase orders started coming in. And now we are like round the clock. We started manufacturing and supplying across India and outside. So this is a little bit, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that's quite a cool story you got there. I feel like we can spend like a whole hour dissecting and talking about that journey. I mean, going from a hockey player that got injured, and then that spiraled into affecting your application to further in life, and that forced you to find a different outlook in life, right? To find something else you can generate and do it yourself. How old are you currently?
I'm 24.
You're 24. And you started your startup journey, was it 5 years ago?
Yes, I raised my seed investment at my age 19. Wow. And a VC at 22.
So let's talk about the initial product and then the new one you have right now. So initially, sure, with Minion Labs, you started with an energy efficiency system, right?
Yeah.
Can we talk a little bit about that? where did that the idea come from? Where did the need come from? How did you build it out?
So I'm a background of electronics and communication engineer. So as part of my academic project, I have to do something, and I don't want it to copy or literally like buy a ready-made project kit and submit for the case of academic project. So I wanted to build something from on my own. So that's how it came. Since I'm a electricity background, I thought like, why not we make an energy meter? And then there are a lot of energy meters. It isn't new. And it's like, if we go back 1650s, the energy meters, like from there it is. So I just did a study and how can my energy meter will be like very unique. And I started with smart meters. So again, I wanted to get each and every appliance level data and make analytics over it. So that time the core value proposition isn't the energy efficiency. I just wanted to get the data. So eventually I ended up with a lot of sensors, bunch of wires, and installing for each and every appliances and with a kind of a gateway. So imagine if your living room is full of wiring everywhere and in between there is a circuit and the wires goes for every appliances. So that was my initial product. And now how do I can't like take this solution to my academic project. Definitely they will put a big zero and send it back. So how can I reduce all these wires? And that's how this machine learning and deep learning came up with. So we just installed one device at made our home itself kind of a laboratory where we started exploring a lot of machine learning algorithms, neural networks, and somehow we figured out an algorithm called a disaggregation, which can able to disaggregate the whole building electricity consumption into appliance level. And it's not a magic, it's more of like an energy signature. Say like I'm installing one of the product at your house and I'm asking you to turn on a laundry machine. So how does a laundry machine works? Number one, it fills water. Number two, step-by-step rotation. Third and fourth will be like a rinse and spin, which will be very fast. If you convert this working actuation in a graph, so while filling water, since there is no motor activity, the graph will be straight. And at a step-by-step soaking, so it will be little ripples will be there. And then at the, while running fast, it will be a lot of ripples. So this is the noise signature of a washing machine or a laundry machine. Likewise, every appliance in the world which consumes electricity will produce a noise signature, which is very, very unique. And all these energy signatures are varied by the time and also varied by the place you keep. Since we are putting a product, Minion, at the MCB panel, from there to the living room, the TV, and from there to the kitchen, if there is any oven, microwave oven, or is there anything, there is a distance between all these appliances. And so there is a travel distance between that appliance to the MCB board. There is that energy signature used to travel back to the wires. So all these things happens in a millisecond. The product which I'm giving, the Minion energy meter, captures the data at like around 4 million data per second. So that's a lot of data. And all these 4 million data per second has been streamed to our cloud. And once the data comes to our cloud, we have a predefined database of energy signatures already trained. Washing machine or the laundry machine means this is how the energy signature looks like. Television means this is how the energy signature looks like. When the real-time data from your building comes to our cloud, we just do a comparison and see which this energy signature goes with what. And once the machine learning algorithm able to tag, then it immediately pop out to the user's dashboard that you have turned on our laundry machine. And when it is on, a time and off time, and if it is running currently, how much it is consuming. So this is like more of a 40% of the solution, identifying that. So now, then there was a question. Even the person who turns on the laundry machine knows at what time he turns on, at what time he turns off. So nothing is new that I'm giving a solution that through a machine learning, artificial intelligence or neural networks that I could able to give you when it is on and when it is off the data. So how valuable I can give the data more. And we started like doing. So until this part, it was my college academic project. And until this part, we got a more than 3 to 4 international awards. And when it just came, after I quit Amazon and I wanted to sell these, so that's where I recognized this data is invaluable, because people already know when they are turning on and turning off. So what value I can create on the data? So I started with the technical sheet. Whenever you buy any electrical appliance, it comes with some star rating or power guide telling like this much voltage and this much the current it should consume. So there are appliances which is like maybe 1 year old, 2 years old, which consumes more than what it is required, what it is mentioned in the technical sheet. But visually, we do not know. We use it daily day basis. And that itself will cost you a lot of energy cost. So how about benchmarking that and telling the people that this machine which you have is consuming more than that. And because of that, you're paying a lot of energy cost per month itself. If you could able to rectify that, maybe a couple of bucks in that for the maintenance, you are, like for next 1 year, you're going to save this much. And that's how the first value proposition came. And it's called asset maintenance or asset benchmarking. And now, whom should I target this? Who has a hazard and where shall I sell? And apparently in India, energy efficiency for hospital is, there isn't any much players. And I know a person who runs a local hospital here. So I just went and pitched him, like, you have a CT scanner, you have MRI scanners, X-rays are there, and those are all very much high cost. And how about you can use a Minion, and I can pilot it for free. You can use it, and once you like it, you can buy it. So we agreed for it, and we installed a couple of Minions. That was the initial pilot which started. And eventually he liked it. And because the CT scanners, MRI scanners all are like very expensive. If something is going to go wrong, it's a heavy bomb cost for him to maintain it. So what if he get an alert prior to something goes wrong so that he can avoid a big cost is coming. So that's how it started. And then we customized the solution according to the recommendations and suggestions he asked for. And the total solution turned around in a hospital energy management solution. And likewise, this hospital I started targeting, and currently there are like more than 25 hospital chains are using Minion energy management solution, around 75 deployments in India. And then at this point where I raised my seed investment, and that helped me to expand to another sector, and we went to retail sector. So here, for each and every sector, these appliances are there, right? These appliances are kind of an ocean. In hospitals, there are different set of appliances are being used. In retails, there are different set of appliances are used. If you walk into any industrial, there are like different set of appliances are there. In order to train these appliances into our machine learning and deep learning algorithms, that is a little bit of a technical challenge. Now, how do I tackle this? So, and then we came up with a more artificial intelligence, or like kind of the deep learning algorithms, which can able to identify these appliances automatically and able to label it. So this alone took me a year time for training these models. And now we started like expanding to airports, to the railway stations, and even we working with a port in Kuwait and et cetera. So this is how the journey actually started, and more of a product.
I mean, you're talking a very like steady voice, but that's a very exciting journey.
Yeah,
that's pretty exciting. Like, would you accomplish quite a lot in a very short time period? And I like the idea that you call in these things minions, right? It's a good name for them.
Actually, the minion, the name actually come up with the product is smaller than your palm size actually. So mini, and this mini creature will be always on to monitor your electricity consumption. So mini on. That's how it came.
Yeah. But in the concept of minion, that's great. So let's talk about the market for this, right? So when you developed this, the market was for, was it meant for residential consumers? Was it meant for like businesses, commercial, or industrial? Like what was the purpose for this?
So we were like initially targeting both consumers and businesses, but once I raised my seed investment, so that's where I did a lot of researchers and did a lot of market research at that point. And then I placed the company or the value prop for the businesses alone. And right now we are opening doors with the consumers also, because for consumer market, the branding is required. And it is not an easy sell in the consumer. It may like make or break. And there are a lot of marketing investment is required to for like making the brand visible to each and every consumers. But in business, it's not like that. And it's more of a cold call. You walk into the meetings and say, convince the client and show the savings for one building. So I target like one hospital and the hospitals with the chain of hospitals. So target one of the building, show them the savings and close the deal with the other rest of the buildings of that particular business. So likewise, we have been targeting all these chain of businesses. And so that got me resources in terms of team, in terms of money. And now once we got the money and the team, now it's a matter of like just allocating the team and the money and let's do the consumer right now.
Cool. And then from there, now you're positioning a new product line, which is these not microwaves, but desanitization equipment, right? I was discussing this with a friend earlier for their podcast. You know, it's a 28 liter unit that can disinfect things using, is it microwaves? Was it?
No, it isn't a microwave, but it looks like a microwave, but it has a UVC lights inside. Like little bit of intro about this UVC. From the sun, there are three categories of UV lights actually generates: UVA, UVB, and UVC. If we walk in the open beaches or somewhere the sunny areas, we get the tanning or else the skin burns, which is actually caused by UVA category. And so that itself, like human can't handle, the human skin is actually fragile and it couldn't be able to handle the UVA itself. And if you even look at like some buildings as a plastic ceiling and they have the sunshades. So after like maybe a year, the sunshade, if there is any color that shades into some orange likewise, that is also a cause of UVA category. The UVB category is much dangerous than the UVA. But apparently that UVB actually gets dissolved at the atmosphere level itself. It doesn't reach the surface, but it will reach the surface at the equatorial region. The UVC category is much, much dangerous than the UVA or UVB. And it gets totally like filtered out in the ozone layer. And there are bulb manufacturers who used to have the mercury inbuilt with this bulbs, and they do an artificial UVC, which is much equal as the UVC, which is generated from the sun. And it isn't a new technology. It's been used for last 80 years, where if you look at a water purifier, UV water purifier, it comes with the UVC lamp. And there are like hospitals who generally uses a similar kind of a UVC sanitizer box in the hospitals to sterilize the surgical equipments. And even if you walk into saloons and spas, you can see the UV box to sanitize.
What is it about this UVC frequency that kills bacteria germ? What is it about that sanitizes?
So the UVC, again, it starts from like 200 nanometer to approx 300. But the specific UVC category, which is used in germicidal purpose, is 253.7 nanometer. And it's been a very, very traditional, as I said, they have been using in multiple places, but we just repurposed the use of the UVC product, because until this COVID-19 outbreak, the consumers doesn't need a UVC box like this. Now we are like, even to go to a grocery shop and buy things and comes, we might not know whether the COVID-19 is contaminated in the packages or the couriers we receive, is it contaminated or not. So people are scared. So to give us safety, and we have come up with this product, which is kind of a microwave box of 28 liters. So they can put even a big parcel inside, sanitize. So right now I have supplied around today 4 products to a VR company. They wanted to sanitize the VRs and inside the box.
Nice. I mean, so is this a consumer product? Like, do you imagine this being inside every household? Is it meant for like businesses to,
it's a consumer product? Yeah, it's a consumer product. Anyone and everyone can able to buy this. And of course, on business side, since I said I've been handling the B2B, business to business side of the energy meters, for me it's a first time experience with the consumer product, and that too I'm like keeping a leg on both energy meter consumer side as well as the Minion UV products consumer side. So a little bit of learning and a lot of homeworks.
No, I bet. Let's talk a little about that. Like, so it's a consumer product. So do you see a world where, like, do you see the demand for this yet, where almost everyone will buy almost a microwave-like system to have in their house to disinfect things that they bring into the household? And if so, what is the cost of these things, and where can people buy them?
So the as part of the business terms, I see a lot of demand. What I did is like we just come up with a one prototype. We took a lot of photos of around the demo videos, and I haven't passed these photos through the digital marketing team. I myself, I just posted like around 3 posts in LinkedIn, and that got me like around 5,000 plus views for each post, and more than 52 products. We just got a pre-order on that. So I just compared with my energy meter back in 2015. I did an email campaign. I did a social media campaign. I went and like more than 10 to 20 meetings around, and I couldn't even able to sell one energy meter solution for the entire year of 2015. And this UV product, I just shooted out only 3 posts, and that could able to get a 52 pre-orders. And initially I had set it up e-commerce in the website where everyone can buy. And after I launched the e-commerce, more than 232 orders came, and without any go, because of the logistics lockdown in India, I had to literally cancel all the orders, which are whatever is from outside, from the Bangalore. And we just had to send the product only in Bangalore. And now the logistics has been little ease, and we started sending email as you can again buy it from us. And the price of the product comes at like around in Indian rupees, it is like around 11,000 bucks. But if I can convert it into US dollars, it should be around $100.
Okay, nice. So it's $100 US for this equipment. And you know, in the description you mentioned it's 28 liters. How big is that? Like, how does that look like?
I can put my laptop, 15.6 inch laptop, inside the microwave oven. It just looks like a microwave oven size of 28 liters.
Okay, so it's a
good and yes, on the telling on the features of the product. If you put any object, electronics or food or the vegetables or anything and everything, it gets a 360 degree sanitization. So we have made it in a way like on the top sides, it may sanitize, but defaultly the base will not sanitize. These microorganisms like COVID-19 or any pathogens, it just needs a small millimeter to live. So we made it very design plan that on the base will be a quartz glass. So quartz has the highest rate of transmitting the UVC lamps, UVC light. The normal glass or any other transparent material will completely block the UVC. Only the quartz can able to transmit it. So we had to keep the quartz glass in a such a way so we can keep the bulb and also we can keep the objects. And this glass should hold the weight of the objects as well. So we made it in a very designed, the planning was gone good. And also there are like certain calculations also for this 28 liters. What is the dosage of UVC have to keep? If it's an overdosage, it will spoil the products which I was keeping, especially vegetables and fruits. And the timing also is like there is a calculation. And so right now we could able to achieve 99% of efficiency or sanitization of with the SARS-CoV-19 sample in 10 minutes exactly.
Wow. Like, I mean, this is important too. Like, even my one of the things I realized, my phone. Like, I realized, like, I take my phone everywhere during this time, and I haven't been sanitizing it. Because, you know, there's only so many times you get a Lysol wipe and wipe it down, you just naturally forget, right? But even groceries, things you bring in, you should be sanitizing. So if you have a convenient device where you're like, oh, you see it on your kitchen table, that you can throw an everyday device into, you can do it in a quick 360 around, you can desanitize it.
Exactly.
It makes it much
exactly.
easier for people.
It's like very instantaneous and you don't need to buy a lot of sanitizers boxes and keep it in stock. Just one box is fine.
Absolutely. I mean, this solves a lot for our supply chain too, right? And for the environment, you're not necessarily buying all these alcoholic products, you're not buying like hand sanitizers, but you know, you have the equipment that can sanitize whatever you bring in the house. And that's really interesting. I mean, what is your production schedule? When can we expect to see more of this?
As of today, we are producing around 100 products in 3 days. And I'm looking to ramp up the production. We have partnered with another a production company recently, but the production is yet to start. Should be starting by next week. So once it starts, I could able to produce around 500 products per day, and eventually that will also increase. And we are right now working with Amazon, trying to list the product there. And the sales right now is happening through the website, completely through the digital marketing, and people just signs up in the inquiry. And we take that forward. But now again, I'm in a verge of like converting that the inquiry to e-commerce again, because the lockdown is eased now. And I'm also looking for these distributors, resellers. We have attractive margins and pricing plans worked out. So this is how I'm going to place and get into the sales and production.
No, that's amazing. And what does the competitive landscape look like? Are there any devices like this in the market yet?
So there are a lot of the devices are there, but few are the handheld, but the handheld devices are, I don't see that handheld devices are much, productive or much efficient, because since we come up with this clinical test and seen the results, how the SARS-CoV is getting reacted to the UVC, it takes a default of 6 minutes to 8 minutes timer, and 10 minutes it's a 400 fold of energy required to destroy this SARS-CoV-2. So if there is a handheld devices, people just like kind of a barcode reader, they just do it, but it is no purpose of sanitizing. But there are few other competitors in the market, and as I said, the competitive benefits again is the 360 degree, and then what is the protective measure for the human is there. Because as I started with the UVC is dangerous for the human skin. So we made the entire package as a UV protective, the product enclosures, as well as it has a lot of safety sensors inside, where at the time of operation, when someone tries to open it or someone tries to put inside any finger or even the hand inside, it immediately turns off the UVC. So there is no chance that the UVC, which is used inside the product, gets a human exposure. And we got a safety certification for that. And we also had covered with the BIS certification, which is electronics component certification. So as part of the compliances and safety and also the design, which would be the competitive benefits which you have?
Interesting. So is there any regulations that prevent you from taking this to market?
This product actually getting classified into scientific and industrial equipments. Hence, there isn't any medical certification or medical requirements is not necessary. Apart from the clinical test and whether this is deactivating COVID-19 or not, this is first test. And second, what will happen to the fruits, vegetables, the consumables if we keep inside? So that test is, these two are the clinical tests which is required. And apart from that, whatever is required for the normal electrical appliances certifications, that is the one which we have already cleared.
Amazing. That's really interesting. So, this is a pretty cool product because it's simple and efficient, right? It gets a very core problem done in our lives, right? It's become a big problem very recently. 4 months ago, this was not an issue, but now it's a very supreme issue, and it's going to persist in our collective consciousness for the next few years. People are always worrying about, what am I bringing to my house? What am I getting in contact with? And it's becoming more of our cultural norm globally to be sanitizing ourselves, sanitizing our things, and keeping and to be socially responsible for you and your household. So I can definitely see this as a household appliance taking off, and really interesting to see how you'll, see this getting to market. Now, talking about that and barriers, is there any barriers when it comes to manufacturing? Because like right now, supply chains rule everywhere. Manufacturing plants kind of so they're having issues with their supply chains and logistics, right? Has there been any issues in getting this into the hands of into a manufacturer and get that made, or how's that been?
So right now, what we felt is like logistics is the kind of a new gold, because previously there was logistics is there, but I never even imagined that logistics is the crux of any businesses. And after this lockdown, I couldn't able to even, we got these orders and we couldn't able to send the product to the client. And in and around of the Bangalore city, we have a normal the porters and a few other trucks delivery, which is inside the city, which we able to do. But outside the city, anything couldn't able to send. And but right now it is getting ease inside the India, and we can able to send across national. But there are a lot of inquiries coming from internationally, from Australia, from UAE, and from UK as well. And a couple of my friends live in US, and they were also like, local, let me know if there is any first flight coming to US from India, like, please send a product to us. So this is like logistics has hit most of the businesses, but it should be normal. And all these people are like finding a way to like, how can we, because logistics is crux for all the businesses, and Corona seem like it may not never go just like that, vanish for like the next morning. So we have to start looking like this is the new normal, and how can we be more productive in this.
I absolutely agree. This is the new normal, and the economy as it is, it's been shifted to a new economy. And I'm looking forward to seeing your product in shelves or in an Amazon fulfillment, right? To get it in the hands of people. So we'll end this episode here. This has been really great. Thank you so much for coming on and talking about Minion Labs and your new product line. I wish you guys all the success and as much support as we can muster. And hopefully people who are watching this episode get some insights into your story, how you built this, and also get a preview of what's to come from Minion Labs. But for now, thanks for everyone who watched, and thank you both for coming on. Stick around for a few minutes. We'll do a quick debrief. But till next time, guys, thank you.